imagine somebody sent you a subtitle project. The timing is fine. You just have to proofread the text. This is a common use case in subtitling, so let's use that to talk about text operations. If you haven't done so already, download the videos and the EZT files for this lesson, and make sure they're all in the same folder. In Windows Explorer, double-click the EZT file for exercise 1, and it should open with the video already loaded. If it doesn't, just go to Video, Open Video File, and select this lesson's video. You can leave the timecode at 0. Oh, and by the way, the EZT file is your subtitles project. It contains much more than just subtitles. An EZT file stores lots of other information, such as your project settings, the video file being used, and other features that we'll see later on. So, for example, in a project where you export the subtitle in several different formats, you don't need to edit each file separately. You just edit the EZT file and then export that to the different subtitle formats you need. Let's start by playing the video. The shortcut is Alt right arrow. This is the right arrow on the main keyboard, not in the numpad. To stop, Alt down arrow, like you're hitting the brakes. To reverse, Alt left arrow. You can also play and pause using these buttons on the playback toolbar. Or with the pause break button if your keyboard has one. Practice using these shortcuts. Try to stop the video at specific positions, such as the beginning of an utterance or at a shot change. When the video is paused, you can also go back and forth frame by frame. Alt up arrow goes forward. Alt down arrow goes back. Notice what happens to the audio. You hear a little bit of the audio from that specific frame, otherwise known as scrubbing. This is really useful to find a specific position, such as the beginning of a word, when it's not clear from the waveform. You can also do this with the mouse, using these two buttons on the playback toolbar. In EZTitles, you edit the subtitle text directly on the video. You can switch between subtitles using page up and page down. When you do, you'll see a cursor flashing at the beginning of the subtitle. Then, you can just type normally, as you would on a word processor. To add a line break, just type Enter on the main keyboard. You can also use the up arrow and down arrow to access all of the horizontal lines. You can use Backspace, Delete, and Enter to raise or lower the subtitles. There are some common word processor shortcuts that apply here as well. You can use Control right arrow, Control left arrow, to move the cursor word by word. Shift arrow keys to select text. Control shift arrow keys to select word by word. You can use Control I to set or unset italics. Control U makes the selected text all caps. Control Z, as usual, is the undo shortcut. If you're using a QWERTZ keyboard, that's Control Y. And now, let's move on to a few other shortcuts that are more specific to subtitling. A common task in subtitling is adjusting the line break in a subtitle with two lines. Normally, you'd do this with Enter, Backspace, and the arrow keys, but in EZTitles, there's a much quicker way to do it. Use Control Up Arrow and Control Down Arrow. Take a look. This can be a real time saver when you have a lot of subtitles to adjust. This operation is also available here in the subtitle toolbar. Another common task is splitting and joining subtitles. For example, suppose we want to join subtitles 1 and 2. We select subtitle 1 with page up, page down. Then we use Ctrl Alt equals to merge it with subtitle 2. Now, suppose we want to split subtitle 2. First, we set the cursor to where we want to split the text. Then we use the shortcut Ctrl Alt Enter. That's Enter on the main keyboard. You can also merge and split subtitles by clicking the Merge with Next, Merge with Previous, and Split buttons on the toolbar. When you split a subtitle, EZTitles has to calculate the timecode of the two resulting subtitles. It can do that in two ways, either proportionally to the amount of text in each subtitle, or by using the current video position. You can configure that under Edit, Preferences, Split Subtitle. There you have the options, split at the current TC, and split depending on the character position. Finally, you can use EZTitles as a spell check. If you click Tools, Spell Check, or just press F7, you'll run the spell check on your whole project. You can configure how the spell check works under Tools, Proofing. As an exercise for this lesson, we've prepared a project with all kinds of problems. Spelling mistakes, line break errors, misheard words, subtitles that need to be joined or split. Your job is to fix all of that. Make sure you check your answer key when you're done.